so this is gonna be a Ulta haul, but it consists of pretty much only Biore and NYX Cosmetics. I think that kind of counts as a drugstore makeup and skincare haul, so I'm just gonna call it that. These are mostly new products, so I wanted you guys to tell me which ones you guys want to see separate videos on. I have gotten a lot of feedback via Instagram, but I do of course want to hear from you all as well. This is why I do these drugstore hauls. I primarily went to get this palette. This is the new NYX Highlight and Contour Pro palette, and it is actually pretty darn pricey. I didn't realize how much it was until I looked at my receipt right now, and it's $24.99. Of course, with the buy one, get one 50% off, you get something else. It's a lot more affordable, but wow. There are 8 pans to it. There's a banana powder, your typical bronzers, and some highlighters. These two shades are primarily matte, and everything else is kind of satiny or shimmery. These are the highlighters. I am wearing this shade in the corner right now as my contour, and I have a clip of me applying it. I was very nervous about it because originally I think it applied very dark, but I blended it out just a little bit with my powder brush, and I think aside from that it looks really, really good. It'd probably be even more defined if I wasn't a bit tanner from my trip to Thailand, but that is probably the shade that I will lean towards. There is one lighter shade, but that one looks a little bit more shimmery, and I prefer to lean towards the matter colors. This shade is definitely lighter as well, but it's a little bit more cool toned, and that won't work as well for me all the time. But I like how there is a variety of bronzers, that you have different shades just about for everyone. And then you have the under eye highlighters, or generally highlighters that are not shimmery, and the shimmery ones. I find this one like super, super pale. I am doing a separate video on this, so I'm not gonna say too much, but let's just say one thing that annoys me is that it makes that noise. I can hear the pans rattling, which means the magnets are not that strong, which bothers me. I mean, it's not magnets per se, it's like you can take out the plastic ring, the pan pretty much, not just the metal pan, and it just rumbles in the palette, which makes it seem a little cheapy. But I do like the fact that you can see the colors and you can see what you're getting and all this and that. It's just, that's something that kind of bothers me. So I am wearing the highlighter in the top right corner and the bronzer in the bottom left corner right now on my face. As far as the other colors go, you're gonna have to wait to see my other video, which will be either like a love it or leave it or review on this palette. If you're more of a cream contour type of person, you'll love these new NYX Conceal, Correct, and Contour Camouflage Concealer Palettes. They look a lot like palettes that MAC has in six pan with different shades. They have like pinkier colors, yellow colors, and of course the darker contour type of colors. I have the light palette and the medium palette. I did not know what I really fell between because right now I'm a little tanner, so I'm pretty sure the medium is gonna work better for me for the most part right now. But when I looked at the colors, I'm like, man, they're really dark. And of course, the light, after I stared at it for a long time, I'm like, maybe that would work for me. Or maybe I need a blend of both palettes. So I got both of them because they weren't as expensive as the other contour palette. And of course, the sale was definitely a plus. So they are $11.99 regularly, and I got them for $9.42 each. In my opinion, $11.99 is very reasonable for 6 cream pans in different colors. These are the only products that I have not tried yet that I picked up because I decided to go with the powder contour instead. But tomorrow I am going to play around with these. You have to let me know down below though which one you want to see first. Do you want to see powder or cream? I know a lot of you will say both, but you have to let me know which one do you want to see. So I am also wearing one of NYX's new blushes. It comes in this little square pan and it has a little circle window to it, a little bow detailing in the front. I'm so scared of breaking this thing. Oh wait, you pop the bow up, guys. You pop the bow up. I'm like yanking at it. So there's a square pan with rounded edges. It's super thin compared to their other blushes, which I like. And this is the shade Pink the Town. It doesn't really look that pink to me. It looks more corally, but that is what I'm wearing right now on my cheeks. I purchased 2 of NYX's soft matte lip creams. I own a bunch, but I do not own these shades yet, and I've been dying to get them. This is shade 19 Canis? I don't know. And shade 9 Abu Dhabi. So I put Canis number 19 on first, which is a little bit more pinky, and then I use the brown Abu Dhabi, which is like a lighter nude, to mix it on top, and it comes out to like the perfect everyday lip color. And yes, I know, it kind of matches my hair, which has faded out to one of the prettiest darker coral colors ever. It's kind of lighter in certain spots too. I'm loving it. I've been washing it a lot more just to try to get it to fade faster, so yeah. As far as lip cream go, I just finished eating Korean barbecue, and this, it's still on. It looks good. I'm happy about it because it's only $5.99 each full price. Now we're going to talk about the NYX Tame and Frame Tinted Brow Pomade, which is pretty much a drugstore version of the Anastasia Dip Brow, which is what I usually use, but I'm wearing this today on my brows. Let me know what you guys think. I tried it on camera, and I can say that it is less pigmented than the Anastasia Dip Brow, But if you think that's harder to work with, if you feel like your brows just look really harsh with the dip brow, you might like this a little bit better. It's definitely pigmented and still gives a nice clean look. I do like it. I had a little trouble with the inner corners a little bit more. If you have a lot of brow hair to work with, I think it's easier to use this. While the dip brow, you don't really need hairs at all. You can pretty much draw in whatever brow you want. This one, it still does that, but it's a little harder, if you guys get what I'm saying. It's a smaller pan, it's a lighter pan, but it's so affordable. I have this in shade Chocolate, which is comparable to Auburn, roughly in the dip brow line, because they have Chocolate too in dip brow, and that's a lot darker. I'm considering picking up the other NYX shades to compare them to the dip brow shades I own from Anastasia. I did that with the Makeup Forever Aqua Brow versus the NYX brow gel that was in the tube, and I compared the shades, and a lot of people loved that video. So let me know if you want to see that with the dip brow and this. Those are all the cosmetics that I picked up, which I know is already a lot. It's crazy. But then I saw some of Biore's new stuff. Now this sucked me right in. I am a big sucker for drugstore charcoal things. I love charcoal. If you did not know, my skin type is oily, acne prone, and charcoal does my skin wonders. So I've tried the Biore charcoal cleanser that comes with a pump. It's pretty good stuff. This is the charcoal pore minimizer, and it has the weirdest packaging. Oh, ew. So it has a pump that you push down here and it shoots right up, which is cool. I guess it kind of, it has like a push pop type of packaging, so the product will get higher and higher up the side till it's all gone. Very bulky, but it gets the job done. I kind of like it. This is a gentle exfoliator that's supposed to instantly reduce the appearance of your pores. I'm pretty sure it's going to take constant use to see any sort of difference. What it feels like is a gel with very, very, very tiny, tiny grains. It's not that abrasive. It's very similar to the St. Ives Green Tea Scrub as far as abrasiveness. And it is pretty nice. I mean, it didn't dry out my skin. It didn't dry out, you know, any area around my nose. But I haven't seen a huge difference because I've only used it twice. I've only had it a couple days, guys. All in all, it's not bad, though. And it did come with a coupon for like $1 off stuck to it. I've used so many bottles of Neutrogena toners that I've been exploring my options now. And I really like this stuff. This is the Biore Blemish Fighting Astringent that has salicylic acid. My face does like a little bit of salicylic acid on and off, like in the cleansers and the toners. Even though I don't have constant breakouts, I am acne prone. So when my hormones like freak out, I break out in tiny bumps. So I like to keep salicylic acid in my routine at all times, but a lot of people do not. The other toner that I used from Neutrogena, I'm pretty sure had salicylic acid as well. This one is like a cooling toner. It has that like menthol-y feel as it is applied to your face. I apply it to a cotton pad and wipe all over my face after I'm done cleansing or exfoliating or whatever the heck. I just always use a toner before I moisturize or do a sheet mask because it preps my skin and gets all of the residue left from the cleanser off. Next is this Warming Anti-Blackhead Cleanser, and it is $7.99. This stuff is good for anyone who loves like masks that heat up. This is not a mask, like it says, it's a cleanser, but it's like a blue gel with little like beads in it. It's not too abrasive. It's a little bit more abrasive than, I don't know, these go hand in hand. They're kind of almost the same texture, but this, as soon as the water touches the product, it heats up, so your hands are kind of like on fire. But heat usually opens your pores, so it's helping the cleanser get really in there and getting all the gunk out of your face. So I do like it. I'm gonna finish it probably. I mean, I feel like I could go through it pretty quick though. It's only 4.5 fluid ounces. It's very, very thick. It comes out a blue texture while everything else usually comes out really dark. But I like it. It has salicylic acid, so I like it. Last but not least is this cleansing bar from Biore. It's a charcoal cleansing bar. And I love to take stuff like this traveling because you don't have to worry about it exploding. And I've been trying the one that was from Yes to tomatoes, I don't know what it is, but you know what I'm saying, Yes to carrots, Yes to whatever, but it's one of those lines and it has a charcoal body bar. I want to say it's tomatoes for clear skin. And I took that to Thailand. That thing was huge. It does not fit in a normal soap container, while this one does, thank God. The other one did make my skin feel a little drier. I haven't tried this out yet. It smells minty and cooling, so I'm pretty sure it's going to give that cooling, tingling sensation. Well, that bar was only $6.99. Can't really beat drugstore skincare. I'm considering doing an updated skincare routine where I have two routines, one being a little bit more high-end and one being drugstore, so you guys can kind of catch a vibe for everything I like to use or switch between. If you're interested in that, thumbs up this video and let me know down below as well. If you enjoyed the video, thumbs it up. Thank you guys as always for watching. Please comment, rate, and subscribe, and I will see you guys in a later video. Can't use it. As far as the hold goes, I will show you guys, I will apply both of these shades on my brows and show you guys a clip right now that really you can't tell the difference. The difference